All right, we are back again. It's the 12th, correct? July 12th, Tuesday, right?
Tuesday.
Tuesday, July 12th.
That's the 13th.
Really? Damn.
13th.
Time flies by.
Yeah.
Hey, you know, July 13th, 2010, and my name is Matthew Wright, Matt Wright, Jeremy Elliott.
Jeremy Elliott.
And, well, we're back again here, and, we just, we're not sure where we're going to start today, but we're just going to play it by ear as we usually do and warming up. My pen is starting to go dead a little, but I've got enough to get through. I've got enough for now, but.
Alright.
Well, we've been getting a lot of response and to our posts and questions and responses. Some people. You know, a lot of people like what we had to say.
We appreciate that, by the way.
And we're going to talk about this. We want to start interviewing people on our show. It's a talk show format. It's almost like a talk show teaching spirituality. I was just, you might have seen my post, read my page for the post regarding supporting one another in this city, helping struggling artists and rappers and musicians and the other people get up. I was thinking that we should interview each other on our Facebook pages and YouTube pages and websites.
Yeah.
Take people you know and say, look, come, let's record this, let's interview.
Yeah.
Let me interview you and I'll put it on my site so my people can see you. And then reverse it, then you go on their website or they come to you. Like, let's say us, like we, somebody asks us to go, let them film us and talking with them. And let them put it up on their website. And all of a sudden, we're up there, and their people are seeing us. We take that person, bring him or her here, sitting right here over here, and we're talking to them, and it's going to our people on our sites. They're getting promotion. And that's what we want to do, have it spread like wildfire, that everybody needs to start doing this.
Yeah, like wildfire. Fire's a good way of putting it.
Wildfire. It's just going to spread out. And it's for your benefit, too. Each and every one of you will benefit if you do this, because what goes around most definitely comes around. And a lot of you have intents on being famous rappers and famous whatever, and making money and being wealthy and rich and famous. But I can tell you, you're not going to get there until you start helping other people get there. And, you know, mark my words, you know, you need to help others.
Yeah, what you... the more that you give, the more that you get, you know.
Important, very important to do that. Don't ever forget that. You got to give. You got to help people. Find people that need help. Do everything you can from the bottom of your heart without an expectation of return. You know, you can know where that it might lead certain places, but don't specifically do it like, oh, I'm only doing this because I'm going to get rich because of it. You might, don't do it like that. You might be able to think that inside, you might know that's a possibility, that's all right. But don't constantly be saying, well, this sucks, but I'm doing it just because. You got to probably be joyful while you're doing it, that adds power.
Yeah, regardless if you're making money or not.
Or not, it doesn't matter about the money.
You don't have to be, you know, rich in the sense of money, but you can be rich in the sense of karma or
the power.
Feeling. Happiness.
Yeah, exactly. You know, that's what we're trying to explain here. You know, I want to give credit to a lot of people that are supportive of this idea that have written me. I want to say to Chi-Chi that we're going to get back with you, man, on this. And, you know, like, thanks for seeing the power of this idea. I know you do. You're a smart young brother, Chi-Chi. Yeah, good. You think well. I know you. I feel within me you saw the power of the idea of multiple interviews, everybody helping one another, and quitting the hating and the trying to bring people down and stuff. I know you see the power of that. So does Boudin.
Universal help. You know, everybody helps each other. Like you said, it'll spread like wildfire.
If you don't want Richmond to be a famous town, that's the only way to do it. What do you think they did in Atlanta? a lot of you young dudes are into rap music and stuff. A lot of people talk about Atlanta being a rap city and all of this. What do you think happened there? Were they all fighting and competing with each other, saying, "Oh, you suck," and hating on each other?
Yeah.
They would have never gotten there if that had been the case.
Exactly.
Yeah, in fact, they were actually helping each other. They were bonding together as groups and lifting one another up, and that's what needs to occur in Richmond, Virginia.
Absolutely.
And I think it's occurred some in Virginia Beach and certain people down there.
Yeah.
And well known. It occurred in certain people there, but not as much as it needs to be.
Yeah, this can blow up a lot more in a positive way, you know.
Positive. That's what we're looking for, not negative.
Yeah, no negativity, no arguing, no bickering. Just let's help each other out, do the best we can. And
correct.
We will get there, you know. Everybody will get there.
I understand that we're here to help, and, you know, we're here to help everyone, you know, bring people together. That's what we're here for, to bring people together.
Unity.
And unity.
Yeah,
unity. You know, and no more bickering.
Yeah, the bickering's got to stop.
And the hate's got
to
stop.
I made a comment today to keep my work in contact, you know, keep my work in line. I have to keep my own mental stability and not be a mental slave to the day-to-day life things that, you know, bring me down. I'm learning this as I go along, but I'm definitely learning.
You can't be a slave to daily life.
Not all the time.
You know, not at all.
Not at all.
You know, you can't. That's a lot of people are money slaves and work slaves, slaves to their jobs, slaves to the landlord. And you know, like there might not be official slavery as there was in the 1700s, 1800s. I guess, of course, not like that.
No.
But yet. Yet this world is full of slaves, and not just black people, white people, red people, yellow people, everyone, you know, green people. We're all like, majority are slaves and don't even know it.
Yeah.
You know, there's a very few select at the top of the pyramid who know what's really going on. We could call it the elite, maybe, who are trying to manipulate events.
I mean, we would just suggest that you go with your dream, try to follow those dreams, make them come true. You know, if you have a talent, a secret talent, some kind of talent inside you, use it. Use that ability to conquer the world. You know, you really can. You know, I know it's hard. You know, everybody needs a little bit of money, this and that, you know. And, you know, but if you put your balls to the wall, in a sense, you know, you're going to get results. You know?
That's
you
right.
You just have to work. You know, like I said, I know some pretty talented writers, poets, musicians, artists.
You could.
They could go a long way.
Speaking of that, I said
they could go a long way if they just would, you know, expand themselves out and just say, this is what I'm going to do, I'm going to work on this. And hey, you never know what you come out with.
Speaking of art, Daniel, for instance, messaged me last night. And I told him, like, you know, that our names are just spreading like wildfire. I told him about people who recognize me from what we do on the street, you know, walking up to us, and he was amazed at that. I told him we need a great artist, you know, and he's like, well, this, I'll do it anytime. And I knew you'd do it. Daniel's a terrific artist. He can draw stuff that looks three-dimensional. Like, you can stick your hand in the pictures. Daniel wants to do it. You know, I got him hyped up about it.
Yeah,
we're going to get him. I told him, I was like, you know, I hope you just be able to tune into our minds psychically so we can, you can draw what we're explaining to you.
Project
it into him.
Yeah.
I think he has that ability. I think he does.
Yeah, Daniel's a big kid.
He's not a kid. I keep thinking of this dude, Daniel, as a kid. Shout out to Daniel.
Yeah,
I knew him when he was a little kid, and his, all his little brothers and sisters. Now, all of them, except Christopher, is like 16 or 17 now.
Right.
Like, I remember Christopher, he was like 6 or 5 years old, a kid running around.
Yeah.
You know, I know their parents, I know the whole family, but Daniel is what? He's born, he's in Memphis. He's 24 now, almost 24. You know, it's amazing. I remember when he was 12, 11, like, just going around. Yeah, God, it's wild. And the girls are graduating college this year.
Wow.
His sisters are graduating from VCU and Virginia State University, I think, or